Are you looking for the best Korean learning material for you? Visit talktomeinkorean.com to get the best Korean lessons for you. So technically speaking, you can translate the word he to 그 in Korean and she to 그녀, but you might not want to use those words too often, and let me explain why. Hi, I'm Hyunwoo from talktomeinkorean.com. So you might have seen 그 and 그녀, the words 그. The word 그 is for he and 그녀 is for she. So you might have seen these words in Korean textbooks and also in sample sentences that you can see in Korean dictionaries, English Korean dictionaries especially, and also in Korean song lyrics and movie lines, etc. But the reason that I say you might not want to use 그 and 그녀, these two specific words, too often is because they don't really sound the most natural in everyday spoken conversational Korean. Instead of saying 그 or 그녀, people often use somebody's name or somebody's social title, and even words like 걔. 걔 is short for 그 아이. So when you can casually talk to this person, if this person is your, you know, friend of the same age or somebody who is younger than you, you can say 걔. 걔는 똑똑해요. He is smart. She is smart. Now, this was something that I also found personally very interesting when I was learning English for the first time, because in Korean, if you hear someone saying 걔는 똑똑해요 or 걔는 키가 커요, 걔는 맨날 늦어요, there's no way of telling whether this person is a he or a she. But in English and in also many other languages, you can immediately tell that it's a he or it's a she, just because you have to say he is, she is, unless you're using the person's name over and over again. So just like that, we have many other nouns and words that you can use instead of saying he and she. And the reason that you see 그 and 그녀 so often in many written sentences is because, well, 그 and 그녀, you want to specify, but then you want to also generalize it. You never know whether, if it's a love song and you might be thinking of that someone special, and you might be thinking of somebody who is older than you, younger than you, can you really refer to everybody as 걔 or everybody as 선생님, everybody as, you know, 누나? It could be younger or older than you, and there are many different titles that can be applied to the special someone that the listener can be thinking about. So to generalize things, the only way to do it is to make it a little more poetic, a little more formal, not so everyday conversation-like. So that's why many written language contexts will give you these words. And also in academic text, sample sentences used in language instruction books, people say 그 or 그녀 because the words themselves are not the point of those sentences that are given. So for example, a sentence like she is American, 그녀는 미국 사람이에요. The point of this sentence probably is American. She is from America, other parts, and not she. And let's say he is tall. 그는 키가 커요. Of course, Korean people, Korean speakers already know that 그 can be replaced with so many other options in real life conversations. But just for now, because 그 is not the most important thing, as you are learning this sentence or sentence structure, people just go with it. Instead of also just using other titles or names, people omit the subject very, very often. So let's say I'm introducing my friend from America, Cassie, to somebody else. So I can say, my friend Cassie is American. 제 친구 캐시는 미국 사람이에요. And then in the following sentence, I can say, she is very smart. 캐시는 정말 똑똑해요. I could, in writing, say 그녀는 정말 똑똑해요, but I would never say 그녀 with my mouth in spoken words. I would just say 캐시 one more time, or I would even tweak it a little more and make it, you know, more casual and say 제 친구 캐시는 미국 사람인데 정말 똑똑해요. Or if I were to make it a little more everyday-like, I would even say something like 제 친구 캐시라고 있는데요 진짜 똑똑해요. you see the entire structure changed, and I didn't even have to say she again. And another situation where in English you would say she or her or he or his or him or her is when you are describing things. So for example, if you want to say 경화 asked me to carry her bag. In English, you need that her, that word her, right? Her bag. It's her bag, obviously. She did not ask me to carry my bag. But in Korean, you would say 경화 씨가 가방을 들어달라고 했어요. 가방을, whose 가방? We're not talking about it, but we know it's her bag. 경화 씨가 가방을 들어달라고 했어요. So in English, it would be unnatural to not use the word her, but in Korean, it would be unnatural to actually use the word for her. Just say 가방. Unless, of course, she's talking about somebody else's bag, not her bag. In that case, she would say the person's name. So all in all, you might see the words 그 and 그녀 in so many written sentences, but in spoken Korean, you don't really need to use them as much, and you won't hear people say them as much. So that's my answer. Hope this was useful, and I will see you in the next one. Keep your questions coming, and please visit our website, talktomeinkorean.com, and our store page for all the information you need for our courses and our books and ebooks. 감사합니다. Bye-bye.